Importance of power factor. The power supplied to an AC circuit is given by apparent power. The power used is given by true power. How much of the power supplied is used can be understood from power factor. Greater the power factor, greater will be the power used. If the circuit consists of only pure inductors, then phi equals to 90 degree and power factor becomes zero, showing that no power is used. So we have to add capacitors in a circuit consisting of an inductor and a resistor to make phi as close as possible to 0 degree for increasing power factor close to 1. That is why capacitors are to be connected across motors. Sharpness of resonance and Q factor. 1. Variation of power with angular frequency in LCR series circuit. Already we know that average value of power equals to ERMS, IRMS, cos phi. P equals to E naught by root 2, I naught by root 2, R by square root of R square plus of L omega plus 1 by C omega whole square. By impedance triangle, Z equals to square root of R square plus of L omega minus 1 by C omega whole square. P equals to E naught by 2. E naught by square root of R square plus of L omega minus 1 by C omega whole square. R by square root of R square plus of L omega minus 1 by C omega whole square. P equals to E naught square R by 2 into R square plus of L omega 1 by C omega whole square. Equation 1. At resonance, omega equals to omega naught and XL minus XC equals to 0. Hence, power delivered is maximum. Maximum power P naught equals to E naught square R by 2 R square gives P naught equals to E naught square by 2 R. Equation 2. Substitute equation 2 in 1. Then P equals to P naught minus R square by R square plus of L omega minus 1 by C omega whole square. Equation 3. Graph. The above graph shows that the variation of power P with angular frequency. The peak of the curve corresponds to maximum power P naught at resonant angular frequency omega naught. Li is further clear that P becomes less at low and high frequencies. 2. Half maximum power point. The points on the frequency versus power curve, where power is half of the maximum power at resonant frequency, are called half maximum power points in the above figure, R and S. At points R and S, P equals to P naught by 2. From equation 3, P naught by 2 equals to P naught R square by R square plus of L omega minus 1 by C omega whole square. R square plus of L omega minus 1 by C omega whole square equals to 2 R square. L omega minus 1 by C omega whole square equals to R square. L omega minus 1 by C omega equals to plus or minus R. Multiply the above equation with omega by L on both the sides. Then L omega into omega by L minus omega by L dot C omega equals to plus or minus omega by L R. Omega square minus 1 by LC equals to plus or minus r by l omega. Therefore, omega square minus r by l omega minus 1 by lc equals to 0, or omega square plus r by l omega minus 1 by l omega equals to 0. But omega naught square equals to 1 by lc. Therefore, omega square minus r by l omega minus omega naught square equals to 0, or omega square plus r by l omega minus omega naught square equals to 0. On solving these equations and rejecting their values, omega 1 equals to r by l plus of omega naught square plus r square by 4 l square whole power 1 by 2, and omega 2 equals to minus r by 2l plus of omega naught square plus r square by 4 l square power 1 by 2. Now, omega 1 minus omega 2 equals to r by l. From the above figure, omega 1 equals to omega naught plus delta omega, and omega 2 equals to omega naught minus delta omega. Therefore, omega naught plus delta omega minus omega naught minus omega delta equals to r by l. 2 delta omega equals to r by l. So we get the